Hi, I'm Aisha. You are watching Educational Hub. Data collection is a systematic process of gathering observations or measurements. Whether you are performing research for business, governmental, or academic purposes, data collection allows you to gain firsthand knowledge and original insights into your research problem. So today we discuss about how to collect data for research. First, we need to understand the term. What is data collection? Data collection is the systematic process by which observations or measurements are gathered in research. It is used in many different contexts by academics, governments, businesses, and other organizations. What are the benefits of collecting data? When conducting research, collecting original data has significant advantages. You can tailor data collection to your specific research aims, for example, understanding the needs of your consumers or user testing your website. You can control and standardize the process for high reliability and validity, for example, choosing appropriate measurement and sampling method. While methods and aims may differ between fields, the overall process of data collection remains largely the same. Before you begin collecting data, you need to consider the aim of the research, the type of data that you will collect, the methods and procedures you will use to collect, store, and process the data.
Step 1. Define the aim of your research. Before you start the process of data collection, you need to identify exactly what you want to achieve. You can start by writing a problem statement. What is the practical or scientific issue that you want to address and why does it matter? Next, formulate one or more research questions that precisely define what you want to find out. Depending on your research questions, you might need to collect quantitative or qualitative data. 1. Quantitative data is expressed in numbers and graphs and is analyzed through statistical methods. 2. Qualitative data is expressed in words and analyzed through interpretations and categorizations. If your aim is to test a hypothesis, measure something precisely, or gain large-scale statistical insights, collect quantitative data. If your aim is to explore ideas, understand experiences, or gain detailed insights into a specific context, collect qualitative data. If you have several aims, you can use a mixed methods approach that collects both types of data. Examples of quantitative and qualitative research aims: you are researching employee perceptions of their direct managers in a large organization. Your first aim is to assess whether there are significant differences in perceptions of managers across different departments and office locations. Your second aim is to gather meaningful feedback from employees to explore new ideas for how managers can improve. You decide to use a mixed methods approach to collect both quantitative and qualitative data. Step 2. Choose your data collection method. Based on the data you want to collect, decide which method is best suited for your research. Experimental research is primarily a quantitative method. Interviews, focus groups, and ethnography are qualitative methods. Surveys, observations, archival research, and secondary data collection can be quantitative or qualitative methods. Carefully consider what method you will use to gather data that helps you directly answer your research questions. Data collection methods. 1. Experiments. To test a causal relationship, manipulate variables and measure their effects on others. 2. Survey. When to use. To understand the general characteristics or opinions of a group of people. Distribute a list of questions to a sample online, in person, or over the phone. 3. Interview, focus group. To gain an in-depth understanding of perceptions or opinions on a topic. Verbally ask participants open-ended questions in individual interviews or focus group. 4. Observation. To understand something in its natural setting. Measure or survey a sample without trying to affect them. 5. Ethnography. To study the culture of a community or organization firsthand. Join and participate in a community and record your observations and reflections. 6. Archival research. To understand current or historical events, conditions, or practices. Access manuscripts, documents, or records from libraries, depositories, or the 7. Secondary data collection. To analyze data from populations that you can't access firsthand. Find existing datasets that have already been collected, from sources such as government agencies or research organizations. Step 3. Plan your data collection procedures. When you know which methods you are using, you need to plan exactly how you will implement them. What procedures will you follow to make accurate observations or measurements of the variables you are interested in? For instance, if you're conducting surveys or interviews, decide what form the questions will take. If you're conducting an experiment, make decisions about your experimental design. 1. Operationalization. Sometimes your variables can be measured directly. For example, you can collect data on the average age of employees simply by asking for dates of birth. However, often you'll be interested in collecting data on more abstract concepts or variables that can't be directly observed. What is operationalization? Operationalization means turning abstract conceptual ideas into measurable observations. When planning how you will collect data, you need to translate the conceptual definition of what you want to study into the operational definition of what you will actually measure. For example, the concept of social anxiety isn't directly observable, but it can be operationally defined in terms of self-rating scores, behavioral avoidance of crowded places, or physical anxiety symptoms in social situations. 2. Sampling. You may need to develop a sampling plan to obtain data systematically. This involves defining a population, the group you want to draw conclusions about, and a sample, the group you will actually collect data from. Your sampling method will determine how you recruit participants or obtain measurements for your study. To decide on a sampling method, you will need to consider factors like the required sample size, accessibility of the sample, and time frame of the data collection.
3. Standardizing procedures. If multiple researchers are involved, write a detailed manual to standardize data collection procedures in your study. This means laying out specific step-by-step instructions so that everyone in your research team collects data in a consistent way. For example, by conducting experiments under the same conditions and using objective criteria to record and categorize observations. This helps ensure the reliability of your data, and you can also use it to replicate the study in the future. Step 4. Collect the data. Finally, you can implement your chosen methods to measure or observe the variables you are interested in. Examples of collecting qualitative and quantitative data. To collect data about perceptions of managers, you administer a survey with closed and open-ended questions to a sample of 300 company employees across different departments and locations. The closed-ended questions ask participants to rate their manager's leadership skills on scales from 1 to 5. The data produced is numerical and can be statistically analyzed for averages and patterns. The open-ended questions ask participants for examples of what the manager is doing well now and what they can do better in the future. The data produced is qualitative and can be categorized through content analysis for further insights. Thank you for watching. Like, share, and subscribe my channel for more informative videos about research.